itself?
No, it has certain distance, 180
Oh,
degrees.
so we learn
That
two
much
things.
that
What
much
happened
we
to
can
my
do.
Everything is getting recorded here.
Yeah.
What you are talking.
Okay, sorry.
What happened to my
We learned two things today.
What happened to my body?
By the wounds of Jesus,
yeah.
I am already
healed.
By the wounds of Jesus, I am already
healed.
And secondly,
learn.
I eat the body of Jesus. I drink the blood of Jesus. Jesus lives in me.
Yesu kwai iya.
And I live in Jesus.
Anda kwai Yesu.
You say?
Wash.
Come on, wash.
Wash. Wash leme maenia. Ashamu kum Yesu. Yesu. Amaduri mupa Yesu. Yesu kwai iya. Anda kwai Yesu.
I eat the body of Jesus.
Ashamu kum Yesu.
I drink the blood of Jesus.
Amaduri mupa Yesu.
Jesus lives in me.
Yesu kwai iya.
And I live in Jesus.
Anda kwai Yesu.
Now when we were saying these words,
kinoweka uwe shulembe maeni,
we saw with our own eyes,
waneno kuwangu wakiwa,
so many people being delivered.
Darwa pol kinuanga beragonya.
There are so many of them vomiting.
Darwa pol akesa.
So many of them rolling.
Darwa pol kibeka nyeniri ngom.
It is the word of God that heals. God sent his word and healed and delivered his people. So shall we pray to God to heal you? Shall we pray to God to heal you? Nobody's talking.
Aaron.
Can we lift our hands and pray to God to heal
you? You chupu do shingwa malo kara mungu kei kumwa.
Very good. Because now you believe.
To ikum kawono daro ni yiu.
By the wounds of Jesus, I'm already healed.
Kurempa Yesu Kristo do ngadaro ni kei.
Okay. Now in the Bible, there is a passage in Mark chapter 5 that there is a man named Jairus. He is a synagogue official
and
having a great position. His daughter is at the point of death. So Jesus has just got out of the boat.
So yes, and
a big crowd has come to hear him. Jairus comes to the beach. He falls at Jesus' feet. Worships him. And tells him, please come to my house. Lay your hands on my daughter. And she will be well. Jesus does not speak a word. Jesus starts walking to his house. Jesus leaves the whole crowd and goes after one man. And the crowd is following Jesus. And the crowd is pressing on to Jesus. Now listen to this. The Bible says,
Biblia washo,
there was a certain woman who had an issue of blood for 12 years. She had a bleeding problem for 12 years. What problem she had?
Ugama tego, angome berukure?
The flow.
For how many years?
Di orari?
For how many days?
Di nindadi?
For how many weeks?
Eh, piyengadi?
For months?
Di duwi?
For how many years?
Di orari?
So if a woman has got a bleeding problem,
kiriwa dakwana berukul, pekumi malpari mikume?
For 12 years.
Di ora parario?
Will that woman be strong or weak?
Uparare daku eno nyu eshumbe de matekulu yuke eshumbe daku goro dong matwe.
Will she be strong or weak?
Eshumbe de tekulu yuke goro ugam.
Okay.
That then she will be weak.
She has suffered many things of many physicians.
Esen enyo dupima pol ile miremu pare shamania nye pare chumunu wango kukeyo.
So she had gone to many doctors.
Ewoti bang dakitari nyuke kadi ajoga gima pool.
She took many medicines.
Emwa nyu kundi yati chege chege.
She spent all that she had.
Enyo tu jemini sheke mananga berugule pikwa pare.
But nothing was better.
Endo pimo kumu lokere ma ber pikwa pare berupe.
The Bible says.
Lempa mungu gamu washu.
She grew worse.
Lemene gamu medene mani saki kwa pare.
These children are small.
Awiye kitendo.
They are growing to become a man and a woman. Gibe
dongo ni daku, dalama dongo, shokumon.
But those who are already grown.
Enda dalama dongo, daro ni dongo romo.
Do you grow?
Dongo dongo kendo.
But the Bible says.
Enda lempa mungu be washo.
This woman.
Daku enu.
Was growing worse.
Ubeduka lempa ni beka lokri no marash maniloyo.
How can a woman grow worse? That lady who got healed of the crutches. For 4 months. She was growing worse. Because she was with pain. The doctor gave her crutches. She was growing worse. So how come today? What did not happen in 4 months? She grew better. How can a person change from growing worse to growing better? The Bible is giving us an answer. If this woman was having a bleeding problem, the whole day, what is she thinking? A healing or a sickness? Her problem or a solution? What is she thinking? What do you think?
Uparo ni parano.
When you are going through some problem.
Kaibe kadi pekumoku imke parano.
Magdalene. What do you keep thinking?
Uperuka parano kaibe kadi pekumoku.
They should look for a solution.
Is that what you're thinking, Magdalene?
Enandale me mandu uparo.
Magdalene, are you telling the truth?
Ube yeru le manda kiri kiri.
If you have bleeding problem.
Kautie kurimol parimikumi.
The money is gone.
Saying that they don't pay.
The medicine is not working.
Pay power they be paying.
Many doctors gave you promises.
Doctors mapul giwashiri lembe mokum mania kumibikai.
And instead of getting better,
ikini manao makudokai una bin.
You're bleeding even more.
Rimu mal parimu meriru no manisago.
So what will be thinking all the day?
Andai parango ikwaperi. Uparango.
That they surrender to Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 The whole day and night we think about a problem. The whole day the thoughts are problem, problem, problem. The whole day the thinking is my shillings are over, over, over.
Sama checking ang waparo kayo sende tumi komadong do limutum.
Now there are no shillings left.
Kawono sene den bema kumudo.
Magdalene.
Huh?
When there are no shillings left.
Kasene premudo ikuope ikumido.
What will you be thinking?
Iparango.
No shillings.
Uparango kasene tumikumu.
Sicknesses all the time more.
And the remu keolo kumene na meda.
And all your family has rejected you.
Pashu jupo usheke daru mupu kuwa kukizei pashu muku erida liku mremu peri.
According to the law, you are unclean.
Ah, kote shik niya ya dong rimu peri jau kete dong iti ngol lengi kim.
Nobody loves you.
Daru ngati mungu mume ipe.
Everybody hates you.
Daru sheke udegi.
Everybody rejects you.
Daru sheke ki kwedi dong.
What will be your situation, Magdalene?
Karima eri, iparoni alemi bekati ii enoro, bedu neledi.
This is our life.
Any kwa mwa wa dano.
We all go through this.
One cheke wa kati kodile makumero.
And as long as I'm thinking all these problems.
Kasa cheke donga be pariku lembe ma be kati e.
Nothing can get better.
Lembe mongu machopu lokre ikuwa parape.
It is only going to get bad.
Endo lembe nebi nyotere baku rash masago.
In your village.
I pashumuku nweni.
There are many dogs.
Agogi e utie mapol.
Does anybody have a dog at home?
Natimoku tie kukuoki pashupari keni kindwa keni. Ukata shingo ka utie.
Anybody having dogs at home?
Natimoku mutie kukuoki pashu.
Yes, I don't have.
Do you give your dog a name?
Ushaku nyin guok mureni eh.
Or do you call a dog dog?
Kono nyo luomu guok.
Guok.
Guok. Guok.
Go.
Uluomu guo kono nyoshako nyingi.
Go.
That they give a name.
Now that name is a you are giving it.
A nyingu ba mikono.
Do you speak your language to the dog?
Uwezi ukudangu giu ni kuwa me.
Do you speak your language to the dog?
Uwezi dangu mu dap mu e ni kuwa me.
That they speak.
Does the dog understand your language?
Don gome gome nyang ikodil lembe nyunying mushako iko igne.
They understand.
So if you tell the dog, come here, does he come?
Kai wa shi niko bine bine.
You tell the dog, get out of this place.
Aishen buka kani esedo.
They surely.
So the dog. The dog learns the language of a human being.
Gok ponju.
So do you need to tame the dog?
Dong nyo umaku guok dong guoki pasumu?
Hello?
Dong nikum lama eri nyo umitu guok guoki pasumu?
But do we learn the language of the dog? Wow, 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 wow.
Uponju nyo dampa guoke unu miyo nying ente unke nyo uponju dampa guok wow 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 kite ma guok timre no.
They don't do.
So you are able to tame the mind of a dog.
Kato unke uchopu loko paru pa guok.
If a mind of a dog can be tamed, how much more your and my mind can be tamed?
Toko uchopu loko paru pa guoka guoka e. Kato ini dana dana zo eke. Paru perishopu lokrero kani.
Right from childhood,
ni shaku inyatin perikwe.
We were taught,
paru peri,
to think about a problem.
Ni pare kumlembe peri.
Our mind is full of problem.
We pon kumlembe mube sendi.
We imagine the problem.
I pare kumlembe ne.
We talk the problem.
Wawezi kumlembe ne.
We feel the problem.
Wapon kumlembe ne.
We meditate on the problem.
Waluoti kumlembe ne.
We cry on the problem.
What?
We pray to God about a problem. Now when a person is doing that, he is getting worse. For example, the lady with the crutches. She was thinking, God will heal
you.
No healing came. Tomorrow the healing will come. It never came. One month went. 2 months went. 3 months went. 4 months went. The worry began to increase. As long as you are thinking on worry, God cannot work in your life. And
As long as you
are
worried, as long as you are in doubt, as long as you are in fear, you are allowing the devil to work in your life. God can work. Holy Spirit can work only when you give him the word of God. Hallelujah.
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 Did you eat your lunch?
Ushamu shami kishenge ni ya kweli.
Shamu shami kishenge.
Ushamu kishenge.
Shamu.
Ushamu.
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 Ushamu. Now you eat the food.
Ushamu usham.
And the food is in your stomach.
Shamu tia ide iyi.
You are sitting here.
But
your stomach is working on that food.
Men, yo.
And the stomach is converting that food into calories.
Man, shamen
and when the fuel is more. Now you can dance. What if you don't eat food for 10 days? The best music is played.
Music is played.
The music is good. But there is no fuel in the body.
And the
in the same way, when you are hearing the word of God, the word of God is a food to the spirit. The word of God is the food to the spirit. So I eat my physical food with my mouth. I eat the spiritual food with my ears. Just as I eat the spiritual food, I also eat the words of the doctor. I eat the words of others. I eat the words of my spouse. I eat the words of my mother-in-law. I eat the words of all my problem with my ears. Now which word is inside you? God's word? God's word? Or problems? Whose word is inside your spirit? Which one are we more attentive? Somebody speaking God's word, and somebody saying, you know that woman over there? I want to tell you something about her. In India they do that.
In India,
in Uganda?
In Uganda,
is somebody talking about somebody? Is that right?
They don't block their ears.
Your ears are open?
Itu ibera yaba? Shikire geuni winjo lembere?
So your condition is going to get better or worse?
That's even worse, more worse.
But you still keep your ears.
And that as soon as you begin to eat the winjo lembe.
For example,
Kulapur.
I told you.
I wash you.
An example.
That
tree you see in the front?
12 o'clock
in the afternoon. 12 o'clock in the afternoon.
Okay, so
Don't ever stand under the tree. There are demons on the tree. They will catch you. Supposing I told you that. It is an example. Hello. Hello, it's an example. Others, everybody is looking at the tree. Now I told you that. And it started raining. And you went and stood behind the tree. Suddenly you remembered what I said. Will you be under the tree or will you run away from the tree?
She will walk away. She will not run under the tree but walk away.
Why? Because that word has brought fear into you. Every day we talk in the ear. Whatever we hear decides our future. This woman was hearing the words of the doctor. This woman was hearing the words of the sickness. Every time she saw blood, the blood was saying to her inner thoughts, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. I will go with you in the grave. I will never leave you.
Now
if she is hearing all this, will she get built up?
Don't get a window lemon again and that what are a
or will she grow worse?
Couldn't you get lamp by a bit in your telemanisago?
Praise the Lord.
Pack me work.
How many of you want to grow better?
Dana Dima give me to get down, get up my bed, come again.
I said, how many of you want to grow better?
Dana Dima give me to get down my bed, come again.
Okay, here's the secret. This woman will give us the secret. When she had heard of Jesus, when she had heard of Jesus, she had not seen Jesus. You have not seen Jesus. I have not seen Jesus. But we are hearing of Jesus. This woman also heard of Jesus. She came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straight away the fountain of her blood was dried up. And she felt in her body that she was healed of that
blade.
Is this a real thing? I can prove to you this story is not true. Does anybody want to challenge me? Let's say I'm not a Christian.
You're
all Christian. And I come here and I tell you, the story is not true. Magdalene, the story is not true. Anybody wants to challenge
me?
Not one woman can challenge me. Anybody? Any woman ready to challenge? Magdalene? Okay. Magdalene is ready to challenge. The story is true or false? Give one moment.
Lele madukwan
ni kundagu e enanda ento enre ebe wacho enanda ngo wayungo pirango do wacho nea dagu e munu kumbongo pa yesu kuma seli me peke sendre kode ndundu anachela remo gamusho do wano yunea bongo pa yesu kristo le mulu shafare otimu tichandai kome.
But the story about the woman is true. But if someone comes to challenge them that the story is not true, they will not believe, because they believe that when that woman was suffering from the flow of blood, and the moment she touched the garment of Jesus, immediately she was healed. So that is what they will believe in, not someone coming to challenge them that this is not true.
It is not true.
E wa chine eto le manda angoba.
Ele manda pira ngoda kwecha paru kushunye ni akane mulu kubangu wecha. Uremu shoki kome abele wa ngachele mulu kumiesu bendu. Ba uremu kamu shoki kome.
That she thought in this her heart that when she will touch the garment of Jesus, the sickness will go.
Okay, Magdalene, are you ready?
I
challenge you, the story is not true.
Dongebe washi riba donganda banya.
Le matako no to washi no tiengo anda. Okay, let me give you some point.
Remember, meet the wash lemon, okay?
If the woman is bleeding for 12 years, will she be strong or weak?
Kata ku any. Upe remove the shuri pi ora parario. I pare ne chobe teki kunu ye doku tong gor.
E da ku gor.
She becomes weak. Okay. Will she be able to stand?
Tong new e shubu shundu.
E shundu rengori le.
Impossible. Then how can she stand and go after Jesus? Don't let her give me love.
She doesn't believe.
And then we do if I don't move back, don't you hear? So my dad don't move back.
She heard about Jesus and that she knew that the multitude followed Jesus, and then she ran towards them.
Magdalene, let's say this is Jesus.
Okay, just
keep the Bible at the side.
Okay, Biblia, I'm sorry, but we
have to do this. Okay. Magdalene, you are here, give me the mic.
I'll make microphone.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Stand here, brother. Bible there. She's very strong, okay? You have to pass through us. The Bible says
Biblia washu,
the woman passed through the crowd. She was not as strong as you are. She was bleeding for 12 years. You are very strong. Now let us see whether you can pass through us. Magdalene, are you ready? Okay.
There
was a great crowd. Then how can she go? Everybody had come to Jesus for their own healing. Then how can she get to the crowd? She cannot stand. She cannot go to the crowd. She is already weak.
And if she touches somebody,
she'll
be stoned to death. The story is a lie. 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 I gave you a chance. I'm giving anybody a chance. Come and pass through us. The woman is weak. How can she pass through now?
When she found she was weak,
and
she saw Jesus passing and healing people, she failed to pass through the crowd. And she remained where she was, but believed in her heart that wherever, even if she didn't reach Jesus, but still she'd get healed.
Oh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now I'm going to explain to you how this can work.
Okay, you continue to keep them alive. Team Ray.
Now listen.
From
the last 2 days, we are learning Romans chapter 10, verse
8.
It says, the word of God is near you. It is in your mouth. And it is in your heart. In your mouth. And in your heart. That is the word of faith. The word of faith. You confess with your mouth. And believe in your heart. Now Magdalene is in a house. She's weak. But she has heard about Jesus. She has not seen Jesus. But what she heard, Jesus opened blind eyes. He healed a paralytic man. He even raised the dead. All those who came to him, they all got healed. He's full of power. He's full of power. He's full of power. He's full of power. Every sickness just falls from him. She began to imagine. And she said to herself, if I touch his garment, I shall be healed. If I touch his garment, I shall be healed. Well, yes, she was saying, God, please heal me. I am sick. Please help me. I am weak. She was talking about a problem. But now, she kept saying, if I touch his garment, I shall be healed. When a person speaks and believes in his heart, the word of God, faith starts growing, fear starts fleeing. When fear is growing, the person is growing worse. When faith is growing, fear is leaving. So Magdalene is saying, if I touch his garment, I shall be healed. Now it is faith, the power of faith, that gives us power in a body and makes us strong. Understand? I'm Magdalene. Okay? Now when she saw the crowd, she did not say, oh my God,
Mungu para.
Who will help me?
Ngama bikonya nikati kindarwe.
How will I go through the crowd?
Abikati kindarwe nenedi.
There are so many.
Daru ponga
kesho. And Jesus is there.
Eko Yesu ndiye aliwaza.
Who will help me?
Ngama bikonya.
Who will help me?
Ngama bikonya ya.
She never said that.
Ewe shungoma enu.
She continued to say, if I touch his garment, I shall be healed. If I touch his garment, I shall be healed. If I touch his garment, I shall be healed. The words coming out of her mouth are the words of faith. Now faith will go and separate them. And she will pass through. That is how faith works. When people are sick over here, we don't pray. We speak the word of faith. When you speak the word of faith, the word of faith, when it leaves the mouth, the person who is hearing, the word of faith will go and do the job. That's why I was there on the stage. I was speaking. My brother was speaking. We did not touch anybody. But the word of faith moved into this ground and began to deliver people. Began to heal people. Began to transform people. And that is what we got to learn. You take a rosary and on the rosary beads, keep on saying the words of faith.
Exactly, which
when you say those words of faith, those words of faith will destroy the work of
faith.
The Bible doesn't say, when she saw the crowd, she went into fear. She went into worry. But she said to herself, even now your mind is talking to you. Words are not coming out of your mouth, but words are working in your mind. And those words are going to produce faith or fear. When a person is repeating the word of God day and night, the person is growing stronger and stronger in faith. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. And that's the time.
Amen.
And at once the power came into her. Now the disciples of Jesus were touching Jesus. The crowd was touching Jesus. But power did not come into anybody. Power flows in that person who speaks the word of God, who believes the word of God. When you believe the word of God and you speak the word of God, the power of God flows. So are you willing to believe the word of God? Hello, are you willing to believe the word of God? Are you ready to speak the word of God? So we will take the same words. You will say, Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes,
say that.
Yes,
listen, when you say, Jesus, I'm touching your body, believe, Jesus, I'm touching your body. Jesus, I'm touching your body. And your power is flowing into my body. And the Bible says, when the lady touched Jesus, the power went into her body and she was instantly healed. Did she ask Jesus to pray over her? Did she ask Jesus to heal
Jesus said to her, your faith has healed you. The disciples asked Jesus, so many people are touching you, and you are saying, who touched me? And Jesus looking around said, he looked at the woman, and the woman came and testified. And Jesus said, daughter, your faith has healed you. Jesus is saying to each one of us right now, it's not he who will heal you. It is your faith that can get connected. The disciples were so close to him, but nobody experienced the power. They touched him. The crowd touched him. But the power did not flow. When does the power flow? When you confess with your heart, when you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. So are you ready to touch Jesus? Are you ready to touch Jesus? Are you ready to touch Jesus? In the next 10 minutes we will see impossible things happening possible. In the next 10 minutes, we will see miracles in this ground. You have to do only two things. First thing, you must confess with your mouth. And confess believing. Confess with confidence. This is the time of your breakthrough. This is the time of your miracle. This is not only physical healing. Healing in your relationship. Healing in your marriage. Healing in your finances. Healing from every kind of fear. Healing from depression. Healing from suicidal tendencies. Healing from every kind of addictions. So are you ready? Will you open your mouth and confess? God is not forcing anybody. Because he gives everybody the freedom to choose. He doesn't force anybody. It is you who should change your thinking. It is you who should imitate the woman with the issue of blood. On that day, there was a great crowd. Nobody got healed. The woman did not even ask Jesus. She took her healing by force. Your faith connects you to God. Your worry connects you to the devil. You can pray the whole day with worry. Your life will still be miserable. A person who believes by faith, he agrees to what God's word says. He does not agree with the situation. He does not agree with the emotions. He does not agree with the feelings. He does not agree with the knowledge of the world. He does not agree to any knowledge that contradicts the word of God. And this is the challenge. So are you ready?
See, the very thing you are not responding, I don't think I
should say. Kati pe washu tia yika, ube gamu ngo kutegu pe nyutu ngo yismuni ya waya lembele nyu ube mondi kumu. Kamu tia yika.
So with the same vigor, are you ready to fight?
Kamu keru muso, kutia yika ni kendo luis mungi
uu. Are you ready to fight?
Kutia yika ni kendo luis mungi.
So let us close our eyes. I want you to stand up.
Amitu shungu malo.
Come on, stand up.
Uai shungi.
Close your eyes.
Ufungu wemu mi wemu kikiki.
And we will do the same.
Wapiti mo delembe ma Roman.
What the woman with the issue of blood did.
Madaku mamri mo beti mole kumeotimu.
Because the word of God is the same.
Kumlempa munga lakrengo e Rom.
The word of God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So are you ready?
Come to Ika.
Ika.
Come to Ika.
Okay, close your eyes. And say this. Loving Jesus. Loving Jesus.
Yesu miramara.
I love you.
Amen.
I thank you for teaching me the truth. You looked at the woman with the issue of blood with mercy and kindness. You are a merciful God. I can see with the eyes of faith.
Achopuni neno iisheni.
You are standing in a mess.
Nia ibe shungu iishungi kiloeni.
You said where two or three are gathered.
Iwasho kamatanari enyate kushokriye.
Gathered in your name.
Makishokri nyingi.
You are in a mess.
Itie ikingi.
I cannot see you, Jesus.
Ashokungoni neni wangu wang.
But I believe.
Endo iyo.
With all my heart.
Ushunyaza.
You are standing next to me.
Nia iti ngeta.
I stretch my hand towards you.
Ariye yoshinga ikumi.
And I touch your body.
Mana mulu kumi.
And like the woman with the issue of blood,
Shalomata kumu beru kumol parimi kume.
Your power is flowing into my body.
Tegu peri be mondo ikuma.
Your power is flowing into my life.
Tegu peri be moli kwapara.
So let us repeat again. Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Benua ima e yes be mulu kumi.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes be mulu kumi.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes be mulu kumi.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, abe mulu kumi.
Your power is flowing into my body.
Tegu peri be mande kuma.
Your power is flowing into my body.
Tegu peri be mande kuma.
Your power is flowing into my body.
Tegu peri be mande kuma.
Your power is flowing into my life.
Tegu peri be mande kwapara.
Your power is flowing into my life.
Tegu peri be mande kwapara.
Now let's say together, Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Wewe jekta shelu yes abe mulu kumi.
Your power is flowing into my life.
Tegu peri be mande kwapara.
Now let's repeat it together.
Wabe wish tashelo ba. Yesu abe mulu kumi. Abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mande kuma. Yesu abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mande kuma. Yesu abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mande kuma. Yesu abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mande kuma. Yesu abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mole kuma. Yes abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mole kuma. Yes abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mole kuma. Yes abe mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mole kuma. Yes abe mulu kumi.
You say. Everybody.
Dano sheke wa shilembe ni.
Yes abe
mulu kumi. Tegu peri be mole kuma.
Yes, The power of Jesus brings deliverance.
Teko pa Yesu be kelo bondo.
As you're saying, come on.
Chalo mo be wishu leven it go you be timere.
This is a prayer for you.
Eno te sawa peri kare peri.
To take your miracle.
Ni nuango be na gonya peri tangu peri kayo peri.
This is a prayer for your miracle.
Eno te kare mita yo peri tangu peri.
Keep saying,
Washasu, Wamadu Ashidigi.
You are experiencing the power of God in you.
Take up a mongo,
the Spirit of God is working now.
Take up a mongo,
the
people teach
the word. The Spirit of God is the Spirit of liberty.
Take up a people,
there are many women here who have got gynecal problems. This is the time the Lord is healing you. The fibroids have been destroyed. The tumors have been destroyed. Every kind of sickness is being destroyed. Cancer is being destroyed. The power of God is flowing. 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 Satan's power is coming out. Satan's power is leaving you now. Don't stop. Keep saying. Satan is losing his hold on you. Satan is losing his power on you. Satan is losing his power on you. Come on, receive. Everything is coming out. There. Linton.
Ujol, don't move.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus Christ.
Satan is losing his power on you. Keep saying the power of Jesus is taking over. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, keep saying.
I'm
touching your body.
Yes, I'm moving to me.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, I'm moving to me.
Your power is flowing into me.
I'm moving to me.
Your power is flowing into me.
Yes, so I'm moving to me.
Lord Jesus,
I thank you. Yes, I'm for you.
Lord Jesus,
yes, so
I thank you.
I'm for you.
Lord Jesus,
yes, so
I thank you.
I'm for you.
I praise you.
I thank you.
I praise you.
I thank you.
Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
I thank you.
I'm for you.
I praise you.
I thank you.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Ask her to say, Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Wash in the name of Yes, I'm moving to me.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, I'm moving to me.
And your power is flowing into my body.
Take up the molecule.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, I'm moving to me.
And your power is flowing into my body. Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, I'm moving to me.
And your power is flowing into my body. Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, I'm moving to me.
And your power is flowing into
me.
I thank you, Jesus.
For Jesus.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Jesus, abe mulukumi.
Everybody.
That is your watch. Yes, abe mulukumi. Watch us soon.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Thank you, Peribe Maliko. Yes, I'm touching your body. Thank you, Peribe Maliko. Yes, I'm the Mulukumi. Thank you, Peribe Maliko. Yes, abe mulukumi.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Yes, abe mulukumi. Watch us too.
Jesus, I'm touching your body.
Medirika
ask watch. Her to repeat. Ask her to repeat.
No, I let them, eh? No, I let them, I give you, eh?
To this one? Yeah. Ask her to repeat.
In my name, I'm making a way. No, I let them, eh? Yes, abe mulukumi. Tegu peri be malikuma. No, yesu. Yes, abe mulukumi. Tegu peri be malikuma. No, yesu.
In the name of Jesus,
in India, Su,
I bind all satanic powers.
Satani,
in the name of Jesus,
in India, Su, Christo,
every demonic spirit,
shiru,
I command you,
Angalo you,
come out,
Wokshen,
come out,
Wokshen,
come out,
Wokshen,
come out,
Wokshen,
come out,
Wokshen.
By the blood of Jesus,
Purimo pa Yesu Christo,
the blood of Jesus,
Purimo pa Yesu,
the blood of Jesus,
Purimo pa Yesu,
flowing into you,
Ube mali ihi,
the blood of Jesus,
Purimo pa Yesu,
is attacking every demonic spirit,
Ube robu kuti pusheke mushiru,
and destroying it right now.
Mano ben nyoto gidonga romo,
destroy,
nyoti,
destroy,
nyoti,
every evil spirit,
pusheke mushiru,
in Jesus' name,
in Yesu.
In Jesus' name.
In Yingi Yesu.
In Jesus' name.
In Yingi Yesu.
In Jesus' name.
In Yingi Yesu.
Thank you, Jesus.
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 Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Pack me up.
Praise the Lord.
Don't pack me up.
How many of you are experiencing freedom now?
Dadadi bagi be wind you ginu ngiri na gita gonya kawori do. Uting singo maloka ngai ngiri na gonya. Uting pulorunga.
How many of you are feeling? How many of you are believing that you have been set free now?
Dadadi bagi yi shingini ya gita gonya do.
How many of you are free from every kind of pain?
Dana di magi wingi ni ni a gita goya kodi kulito si sheke.
How many of you experience freedom from pain?
Dana di magi wingi ni remu naru ni weku gidong. Nyuke lito muberu magi beri ye.
And how many of you believe that you have been set free from evil power?
So dana di magi yu ni adong. Tegu mi mutu naru ni weku.
Praise God.
Patriot.
Heavenly Father,
Mungu wedu,
we thank you for teaching us this powerful truth.
Wafoi pipo njoe kum lembe mi tegu perieni.
The word of faith,
lembe mi Ishmael,
goes and does.
Eshido mane timu,
the manifestation,
lembe peri,
healings,
kayo,
deliverance,
agon.
And brings the life of Jesus.
Man, eketu ekelo kuapa yesi kuamwa.
We bow down to your Lordship, Lord.
Wa uro iri.
And we thank you and we praise you.
Manu foi manu apeki.
In Jesus' name.
In Yingi Yesu Christo.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand.
Wapeku wapalishi wani Yesu.
How many of you want to celebrate now?
Dana diva kawani eni don give me to kipet.
How many of you want to celebrate your freedom?
Dana di magi mito ki pak mungu mangi foye pi pero metimu.
So are you ready?
Utia ika.
Are the musicians ready?
Ju musicians utia ika.
Come on, let's go.
Aya.
Aya.